Hey guys, my name is Chad and this is Yummy, the most epic and fun cooking show for SA's young foodies, where each week two teams of two young and aspiring chefs compete to win the title and be crowned Yummy Champions. Now joining me in studio this day is, on my right hand side I've got Team M&M and on my left hand side I've got Team The Ghouls, correct?
Yes.
There we go. So ladies, tell me a bit about yourself. Who are you?
My name is Mamuna Heng and I'm 16 years old.
Hey, and you are?
I'm Mishka and I'm 16 years old.
Cool. So tell me, are you guys related? Are you guys cousins?
No,
friends?
We're classmates.
Just classmates. Cool. Can I ask what school?
Zonne.
Hey. And over on my left hand side?
Hi, I'm Fakira Bokka.
Hello.
I'm 15 years old.
And I'm Zizan Koisi and I'm 16 years old and we're friends.
You're friends as well? Same school?
Yes.
All of you, same school?
Mm.
Oh, okay, so you're bringing up the name of your school, I see.
Yeah.
Mm. Okay. So the competition is broken down into three rounds. So the first two rounds are food knowledge rounds. So we're gonna try and suss out who you are as a chef and try and see like what's gonna come out in the final round, which is the cook-off. So in the first two rounds, you get a chance to win brownie points. Now, these brownie points will help you in the final round, believe me. And I'm looking out for the final round because I didn't eat today. So I'm kinda hungry, so I wanna know what you guys are gonna be cooking a little bit later on. But with the final round, you need to make us an amazing dish. I'm talking about amazing dish, like I haven't eaten, and my Tupperware is actually around the corner. So I wanna take some food home, okay? But the deal is that with this meal, it's got to contain our secret ingredient, which I will only reveal to you a little later on, okay? Cool, so with the first round, I can tell you what you're gonna win. So the first round brownie point is going to be extra time. Now, extra time does help you in a time situation like this. It's gonna give you that little edge over the opposing team, right? So for the second round, this is what's gonna happen. You're gonna win this magic key over here. So what this key does is this key will open the magic cupboard. Chef Aisha Suleiman.
Hi.
Who is a professional chef and has loads of experience, but you can only use her once. And okay. Once you're done, you've got to send her back into the cupboard. Same. Unfortunately.
I've got to go back.
Thank you very much,
bye
Aisha.
Bye.
Nice seeing you again.
Thank you.
Right, so everyone understands the rules?
Yes.
Perfect. So the way it's going to work is I'm going to give you spatulas. There you go. You'll be team yellow for now. And you'll be team red. Right, guys, are you ready?
Yes.
Let's start. So, question one. Shiitake, oyster, and button are all what type of vegetable?
Mushroom.
There we go. Well done. Right, so 1.2 team the ghouls over here. Right, next question. True or false, deep frying means to completely submerge food in hot oil. True. I think it's over here. True it is. So now we even 1-1. Well done, guys. Question number three. So this is one of the most commonly used herbs. It comes in the form of either flat or curly. And here's a tip. It's often chewed after eating garlic because it freshens the breath.
Parsley.
Well done, guys. Well done. So it looks like extra time goes to Team M&M. Well done.
Thank you.
So you get an extra 10 minutes. Cool. Are you ready for round two?
Yes.
All right. Question one. What is the outside of a loaf of bread called?
Crumbs.
That
crust.
Was Team Yellow.
Crust.
The crust is correct. So you're already leading with 1 point. Well done, ladies. Question two. When a recipe calls for a teaspoonful of something, what is the amount in milliliters?
5.
Well done. Even Steven once again. Okay, this is the deciding question. True or false? Baked Alaska is a baked ice cream dish.
False.
I'm gonna have to give it to you.
True.
It is. So basically, what Baked Alaska is, it's ice cream covered in sponge cake and then covered in meringue, and then that's baked in the oven. So when you cut into it, you're getting those slices of the three different layers. So you guys get the magic key. So remember that you can only use Chef Aisha
once,
and then she's got to go back. So think about when you want to use her and make sure that it's going to be worth it. Okay. Right, so now it's time to reveal the secret ingredient. Now, I'll give you a few hints. It's actually one of my favorites. Number one, because it's versatile. I mean, it can be deep fried, it can be grilled. I love to bake it in the oven and get that skin come nice and crispy. Any idea what that is?
Chicken.
Well done, chicken it is. Our mystery ingredient for today. So what needs to happen, ladies, is that you've got to come up with an amazing recipe using chicken. Do you understand?
Yes.
Cool. You've got a total of 1 hour to come up with a recipe, get your ingredients, and cook. Yes. Think you can handle that?
Yes.
Yep.
I'm gonna let you go off and go and think about what you're gonna make, get your ingredients, and you sitting there at home, don't you go anywhere. We'll be right back here in Yummy with some more amazing recipes. Hey guys, if you've just joined us, what we have in studio are two teams, M&M and Team The Ghoul, and they've already completed the first two challenges, where Team M&M has won extra time of 10 minutes and Team The Ghouls has won the magic key for the chef in the cupboard. Now, I want to find out what these two teams are making. So, let's find out from Team M&M first. Hi, ladies.
Hello.
How's it going?
Good.
Good, good, good.
So I'm seeing a lot of different ingredients. So who's going to tell me what we're making today?
Okay. We're going to make spicy ground chicken. Yes, with a cheesy veggie bake.
Ooh, sounds delicious. So whose idea was this?
Mine.
Was it your idea?
Yeah, I came about with this sauce.
Oh, so we're fighting teams. Okay, that's fresh.
Yes.
Cool. I'm excited to see what it's going to turn out into. I'm just going to check up on the other side. So let's find out from Team The Ghouls. So tell me what we've got over here.
We're gonna make a Malaysian curry.
Yes.
With rice.
And tell me, whose idea was this?
Both of ours.
Okay, so she said mine and you said both of ours. So who do I believe?
Me.
You. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna start, but obviously because Team M&M has won the extra time, I'm gonna let them go first. So ladies, are you ready?
Yes.
Ready.
Let's see hands before we start cooking. Are they clean?
Yes.
Right. Ready, steady, make it yummy. Okay, I see we're heating up the water first. So what's the water for?
We need to boil the chicken first because I don't think there will really be time to... We don't want the raw chicken, so we
want
to boil it first and then...
That's clever.
Yeah. And then we deep fry.
That's very, very clever. So with the grating of cheese, I assume that you are going to start on
the cheesy.
Cheese sauce. I see. Cool. So what I think is that to move this pot onto that middle burner, let me just actually help you quickly. See, because a bigger flame means that that's going to cook a little bit faster. I hope you don't mind. I'm just going to step in here quickly. So I'm going to move this here. And then it'll go just much faster. So tips with deep frying is, number one is make sure that your oil is at the right temperature. And a way to do that is take a small piece of the bread, pop it into the oil. If it bubbles and it rises to the surface, that generally means that your oil is hot enough to deep fry. And another thing is always make sure that whatever you're going to deep fry, all the excess moisture has been removed, it's been patted dry, especially for them that's boiling the chicken first and then adding into the oil. Okay, yeah, so what's your next step after the cheese has been grated? What are we doing?
I think we'll have to wait for the chicken to... Because we want to finish this first, because like our cheese sauce is, it's really quick to make.
Okay.
So this is gonna take more time.
And then tell me, all the spices, are those all for the cheese sauce, or is that for the actual crumb, for the chicken?
That's for the crumb and for the chicken also.
Oh, is it? And what spices do we have there?
Garlic, lemon and herbs.
And paprika, ginger, and oregano.
Oh, nice.
Okay.
And how long is the chicken going to be boiling for?
Probably another 2 minutes or so, because we don't want it really
You don't want to overcook the chicken?
Yeah, we don't want to overcook
the chicken. Okay, I get that, I get that.
Okay.
Right, so our extra time, ladies, are basically done, which means Team Ghouls, are you ready?
Yep.
I said, are you ready?
Yes.
And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and go! So what's the first step?
You have to cut the chicken into small pieces.
Cool. So tell me what you're making, ingredient-wise. Talk me through everything while you're cutting the chicken.
I'm making...
You said the Malaysian curry, eh?
Malaysian curry.
There we go, okay.
We have to braise the chicken when we're done. We have to marinate it with the garlic and the ginger.
Oh, delicious.
Yogurt.
Cool.
While she's busy mixing the stuff with the in the pot,
mm-hmm.
we have to make the onions.
Yes.
We have to burn the onions to yellow color, to a golden yellow.
Oh, so we're gonna make it nice and brown.
Yeah.
I see. And then this is tomato paste, eh?
Yes.
So what's tomato paste for?
It's basically gonna do the exact same thing as the paprika by giving the color.
And you are furiously chopping those onions. Watch those fingers, please. What spices are we using? So I see some turmeric over there. I see some lovely green chilies, by the way. So what else spice-wise do we have over here?
Roasted masala.
Anything else?
I'm not that good with spices.
Okay, so I assume that we've got about a cayenne pepper or paprika color-wise that
paprika.
Looks like that. Okay, and then this looks like either cumin, coriander. I like the way that you're keeping the coriander in the water. So another tip that when you're cooking is to keep your herbs in water because this keeps them fresh and they keep them nice and strong.
Chicken is taking longer than usual. Than we thought.
20 minutes.
So I've got to ask this. You guys have made this dish before?
No, we haven't. We've been communicating on the phone how we make the dish.
Yeah.
Practicing at home.
Oh, so this was like a phone thing.
Yeah.
And is this recipe from, is it from the internet? Is it from a family member?
No, my mom actually made it before, so.
Oh, is it?
Yeah.
Who knew chicken was a stress reliever? It has two nutrients that are great for reducing stress. So is this your rice? And is it just normal basmati rice? Or what do we have?
Basmati with salt.
Ah, basmati with salt. Cool. And any reason why you're putting the salt in the water?
Because if you do not have salt, you do not have taste.
Did you hear that? If you don't have salt, you don't have taste. Tommy, is that green chilies over there?
Yeah, it's chilies for the curry.
Hey guys, I'm back. Ah, the chicken is coming out, finally.
Yeah,
cool.
I found that.
Okay.
So let's turn that heat
there's
down.
There's more spice here, so.
Okay.
Yeah, sure, work on both sides. Use as much from this table.
So we need that to cool down, because it's too hot.
Yeah.
So.
And then remember what I said earlier about making sure that we pat the chicken dry before we crumb it so that there's no splashing in the oil.
We put this in.
So what's going on with the spices? Oh, we're adding garlic.
Garlic.
Okay.
For the flavor.
For flavor, I like.
Garlic and ginger.
Ginger.
We're adding ginger as well.
A bit of ginger.
So the veg is just cooked with salt, pepper, garlic and ginger.
Yeah.
Mm. Cool, so I would suggest that we use a wooden spoon when mixing. Yeah. Simply because all the fork's gonna do is the fork's gonna break up the veg.
And then you're gonna end up
with veg crumbs. So these teams have about half an hour left, ladies, to get these dishes onto plates. Ah, the chicken's almost done. Yes. And I like how you are getting involved with your hands. That's how I feel cooking should be. It looks liquor. Team M&M, what's going on here? How far are you guys?
We're gonna start cramming the chicken.
Chicken's much cooler now, so
okay.
Yeah, yeah.
So it's cool enough to crumb with now.
Mm.
Okay, that's perfect. I have one suggestion though.
Yeah.
Yes.
Do you not maybe want a clean station for doing the crumbing? Just because it might interfere with everything else that you've got here. Can I help you move things along?
Okay.
Okay, cool. So I'll take the chicken. Are we taking the flour? No.
Okay.
We're just doing breadcrumbs and eggs, you said, eh?
Yeah.
Cool, I'll make some space for you. See, now you've got a clean workspace. Okay. So I'm going to ask you to stop right there and wash your hands simply because you've had raw chicken on your hands and now we're chopping herbs. And while she's washing her hands, we're gonna go for a quick ad break. So we'll see you straight after the break. If you've just joined us, we've got Team M&M's on the side and we've got Team The Ghouls on my left-hand side. And where we're sitting right now is Team M&M's are about to crumb the chicken. And I've got to ask Team The Ghouls, how far are we from finish?
Almost.
Do you think that you'll finish in time?
Yep.
Oh, that's a confident yes? That is a very, very confident yes.
Bye-bye.
Team M&M, How's it going on this side?
So we're gonna start crammy now.
Okay, so nicely coated in the egg.
Okay.
And then we're gonna just...
Yeah.
Oh, that's proper coated in that spice,
yes.
Eh?
My eyes is
burning. Ooh.
So that's spices and breadcrumbs, eh?
Here you go.
See, now it's starting. Yeah. I need to throw still a little more.
Hello, ladies.
Stop.
So tell me what you're doing now. So I've seen you've added in some water.
Now we have to wait a little, and then we'll throw the spices in and mix.
Okay, and then the buttermilk, tell me.
It's gonna give it that liquor flavor.
And the thickness.
Yes.
It's gonna give it that liquor flavor, she
says.
Yes,
and plus, we're gonna make it liquor and we're gonna make it like curry.
I'm just gonna check up on my team.
Yeah, add a little more water.
Are you guys okay?
Yes.
So I wouldn't do this. Just because what's gonna happen is the steam's gonna condense and then you've got water going into oil. Yeah. So it's fine, just stay further back. I'll do this.
I think you should drop the temperature because like it's stored. That's why it's shooting. Did you drop it?
No.
So I think the reason why it's shooting is because that
water
that hasn't been dyed
properly.
Right. Team
we're gonna
the
open
Ghouls.
It.
What's going on over here? Cool. So Team the Ghouls are ready to use the chef in the cupboard, and I think let's get Chef Aisha out of there. Let's see.
Hi.
Welcome.
Hi, thank you. Okay, so I am helping you guys today in what's happening.
I don't know if I should throw this the buttermilk or the chicken
or the chicken first. Okay, get the chicken in there. You can start with that.
Cool.
Okay, so there we go.
There's
okay. So you can see your chicken has started to cook and it's got a really nice thickness and color to it.
The taste.
Okay, yeah, you can taste that.
They feel. I hear a cough.
There we go. Can you see? I think you're starting there.
That cough was caused by me. I apologize.
That was your fault. So what do you say?
I think it's funny.
You think it's good? Are your eyes burning? Are you okay? I think that's a sign that...
That's
and let
curry
it
right
simmer
there.
Off. Yeah, that's okay. Be careful when you, so there's no splattering. Okay, cool. So then you want to let that reduce until it gets slightly thicker than that because you don't want it to be too thin as well. And then I think your dish is all
just
good and well.
Ladies?
Yes.
Are we winning?
Yes, we are.
I think so.
We are.
Just keeping
so what are we doing now?
Cheese sauce.
So this is the cheese sauce. Yeah. So I take it you've added in the flour and you've added your butter and your milk.
Yeah.
And now we're just whisking.
Just to keep always don't stir all like too much.
Okay.
Just
Aisha,
enough so it doesn't.
Unfortunately.
Is it time for me to go?
It's time. I can't have you out of the cupboard for so long. Ladies, you have to be done with her now.
Yes.
Are you done?
Oh, you guys are done. I can go. Oh.
She's
done. That just discard me like that.
She
oh, you have my knowledge and I can go.
I'll take that from you. Aisha, lovely seeing you again.
And I'll go back into my home. Bye.
We're adding in?
Just garlic.
Ah, garlic. So we're gonna have a nice cheesy garlic sauce going over the veg. Yeah. Cool. Into the oven, I suppose?
Yeah.
Is right. The oven on?
And then as soon as that's in the oven, I suggest it's clear. Let's put out plates so we have a nice clean plating station.
And we just want to sprinkle
some more cheesy.
Decoration Indian style, where they give you a lot more rice and a little curry because the curry will kill you.
There is method to the madness. The curry will kill you, so we're going to give you rice instead. Right, guys, time's almost up.
They'll finish
right, less than a minute, guys. Let's go. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Step back. Everything down. Hands up. Firstly, well done.
Okay.
Give us a round of applause. Well done. So before I invite our judges, I just want to do something quickly. Just for social media, I just want to take just a picture so we can, you know, brag about your food. There we go, on this side. Ooh, I like that. And then just because, I just want to take a selfie. Sorry guys. Just a selfie right there. Cool. Ready to see our judges?
Yep.
Yes.
Cool, are you guys happy with what you presented us?
Yes.
Right, so let's get our judges in today. Kayla and Taya, come and join me here, please. How are the two of you?
Good, thank you.
Oh, it's so nice to see you again. So for those of you that don't know, Taya and Kayla were on season 1 of Yummy, and please tell them, but how was it for you?
Well, I really enjoyed it. It was fun cooking against another team.
Any advice that you maybe want to give them before you taste?
Well, make sure your presentation is neat, and it's all up to the tasting.
Cool. So let me just introduce the two of you. So this over here is Team M&M. Now, Team M&M, will you please just tell us what you made?
This is chicken with crumbs.
Mm-hmm.
And this is vegetables with cheese sauce.
So let us go over to here. This is Team the Ghouls. Now, ladies, tell our judges over here what you prepared for them.
We made Cape Malaysian curry, and this is the rice, and this is the curry, as you can see.
Okay.
So tell me, are the two of you ready to judge?
Yes.
I like it. So I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to help them and dish up a little. So let's start on team one.
Okay.
Right, Team M&M, are you ready to be judged?
Yes.
Cool. So actually, you know what? I'm a bit fancy. Let's just do this.
Okay.
We can, just because we can. Right, so each person, I'm going to give a piece of chicken.
Okay.
Right, let the tasting begin. Are you nervous?
Very much.
Very much.
Dig in.
Who needs a knife and fork when we have chicken around? Get right in there. The look on your face. Good. Well, ladies, are you ready to try out what Team the Ghouls have prepared?
Yes.
Alrighty, there you go.
Thank you.
And judge away. Good?
Yeah. It's nice.
It's nice.
Mm-hmm. Very nice.
So I take it you're impressed with both sides?
Yes.
Perfect. Now, you know, because this is a competition, there can only be one winner. But I do just want to commend all four of you on doing an amazing job.
Thanks.
But there can only be one winner. So, the winner today is going to be the M&M. Oh, you guys look so happy.
They are so excited.
Ladies, thank you very much. It's been an amazing day. I mean, I saw people sweating. I saw people coughing. I saw oil spitting. Everything happened in this kitchen today. But from myself, your host, Chad, Aisha, our chef in the cupboard, and obviously not forgetting our lovely judges, Taya and Kayla, thank you very much for coming in today. From myself, your host, Chad January, and Aisha,
chef in the cupboard.
We just want to say a goodbye. Bye.
Bye.